Hello friends. Now we'll discuss an important concept of conformal transformation. In this we'll try to understand what is the meaning of conformal transformation and its related things. If y is equal to f of x is a single valued function, of a variable x, then for every value of x there will be a corresponding value of y, because y is a function of x. In this we can see the set of points x, y describes a curve C. If you take y is a function of x, so y is equal to f of x is a single valued function of a variable, of a real variable x, then for every value of x there will be a corresponding value of y. Then the set of points x, y describes a curve C. Therefore, this conformal transformation is a method of representing complex valued functions geometrically. Means this conformal transformation teaches us, or it says, how to represent a complex valued functions. Complex valued functions omega is equal to f of z geometrically. This is more important. Here we can see two things. One is omega and other one is z. So here omega is a function of z, no doubt. So in future omega and z will be two different planes here. So we'll try to understand its definition and a few related things. What it is, let us see. If you take its definition of conformal transformation, in this, if we consider a complex valued function omega is equal to f of z, and we all know this omega is equal to f of z, further it can be represented as omega is equal to f of z, it can be represented u plus iv. Since here we consider z is equal to x plus I y, therefore automatically we can write omega is equal to u of x comma y plus I into v of x comma y, where z is x plus I y. Then we need to keep few things in the mind. Okay, we'll discuss these points. No doubt omega is a function of x, so omega is equal to f of z, where z is a complex number, that is x plus I y, then omega will be written as u of x y plus I into v of x y. So the complex quantities, if you take a complex quantities, z is equal to z of x y, they represent z plane. Similarly, omega is equal to omega of uv represents omega plane. So there are two different things now. One is z plane, which will be represented by z is equal to z of xy, and another one is omega plane, which will be represented by omega is equal to omega of uv. Here x and y will be ordinates, here u and v will be ordinates. So second point, a point x, y in z plane corresponds to a point u, v in w plane. This is quite simple relation between these two. Means ordinates, so the points x, y in Z plane is having an impact, or else it is having a relation with UV in omega plane. Means if you make some changes in Z plane with the help of X and Y, automatically that changes will occur in omega plane with respect to U and V. Then we take one more point here. What is that point? This is more important point. As we discussed in second one, if a set of points X, Y traces a curve C. Okay, means in a Z plane, if we trace a curve C that is in Z plane, then how it keeps impact on other plane, that is omega plane, and corresponding point UV traces a curve C in omega plane. It is quite interesting. If we trace a curve C in a Z plane with the help of X and Y, automatically as its impact in omega plane, automatically with the help of U and V, the curve C dash will be traced in omega plane. Okay, so generally what it means, a curve C is traced in Z plane with the help of X and Y, automatically one more curve C dash will be traced in omega plane with the help of U and V. What it means? This means a curve C, the curve C is transferred, or we can call it as mapped. Sometimes we call it as transferred, or sometimes we call it as mapped onto, means in all respect onto the curve C dash under the transformation, omega is equal to F of Z, and these are called as images. Means many times we can observe by sitting somewhere, we keep on tracing on one platform with the help of keyboards and all, then automatically the reflection we can observe it on a monitor. So here keyboard acts like a Z plane, whereas monitor acts like a omega plane, and that is called as images of each other. Images of each other means what? If you do something on omega and its impact will come on Z, if you do something on Z, its impact will come on omega. So this is called as images of each other. Then we need to see which kind of images and which kind of transformation is possible, because most of the time we observe when the transformation occurs, it may occur in terms of a direction, or it may occur in terms of a magnitude of that, or sometimes it may occur with respect to both magnitude and direction. If the transformation preserves the angle between two curves, both in magnitude and direction. So this type of transformation is called as conformal transformation. Means what? If the transformation is occurred, the transformation preserves angle between the curve both in magnitude and sense. For example, if we transfer something which is with respect to the magnitude as well as it is with respect to the curve, that is called as conformal transformation. For example, suppose if we draw a curve, something like I take this is z plane and this I'll be taking omega plane. Assume here I draw two curve, this is called as C1 and I take one more, that is called as C2. Then automatically in this direction we will be getting a theta. This is called as the angle between two curve. Here we can see the angle between two curve with respect to the magnitude and the direction, it must be same in the other plane, that is omega plane. Then we can call it as conformal transformation. What it says, suppose if you draw the same one more, if you draw a C1 here, its impact will come like C2 in C1 dash in other plane. If you draw a C2 in Z plane, its impact will come like C2 dash in other plane. Since we have got an angle between two curve, that is theta, here that will be taken as theta dash. If theta is equal to theta dash, then we call it as a conformal transformation. Means the angle, amount of angle and the direction, amount of angle, for example, if I take it between these two, if it is 45 degree angle, here also it will be 45 degree, that becomes a magnitude. Then direction, if it is in this direction, here also it will be in the same direction. Therefore, both magnitude and directions are same between the angle of two curve. So it is called as conformal transformation. Suppose if the transformation preserves, only in magnitude, it is not having any sense here. If it is the transformation preserves only magnitude but no direction, between angle between two curve, then this kind of transformation is known as isogonal transformation. Here two things we need to keep it in the mind. One is conformal transformation, other one is isogonal transformation. Means what? If we trace the same curve in Z plane, automatically we get it, its impact in omega plane. But if the magnitude of this theta is equal to same here as well as here, here also it is 45 degree, here also it is 45 degree. But if it is in this direction and if it is in omega, if it is not following that same direction, or if it is in other direction, or it is there is no matter of a direction itself, then we call it as isogonal transformation. So two things we need to keep it in the mind. To say a conformal transformation, the angle between the two curve must be both in magnitude and direction, they must be same. If only magnitude is same and the direction is not, that kind of transformation is known as isogonal transformation. Then we will be getting a few discussions here. What kind of discussions we will be getting? Let us see. Suppose if we take if we discuss conformal transformation on various functions, here we take one discussion of omega is equal to e raised to z. Whether this function is conformal or not, that we need to check it out. Okay, how do you check? With the previous discussion, let us continue. We consider omega is equal to e raised to z, which is given, where we know that z is nothing but x plus iy. So substitute z is equal to x plus iy in place of z, then we will be getting u plus iv. U plus iv means omega is equal to u plus iv, that is equal to e raised to, in place of z we take x plus iy. So this becomes, as per the property, it is e raised to x into e raised to iy. Further we know this is nothing but e raised to x into, how do you represent e raised to iy in terms of sys theta? So that is cos y plus I into sine y. If you take a group multiplications, then we will be getting u plus iv is equal to e raised to x into cos y plus I into sine y into e raised to x. Then we can understand this is real part and this is imaginary part. Let us separate real and imaginary parts here. So u is equal to e raised to x into cos y is real, and v is equal to e raised to x into sin y is imaginary. Altogether we call it as equation number 1. Then we shall find an image in omega plane corresponding to a image in z plane. We need to correlate. For that, what we do, we shall find image in omega plane corresponding to the image in z plane, and that the image we will take it as a straight line. Means in z plane we will be taking a straight line which is parallel to the coordinate axis in z plane. So let us see how it works. Means we are trying to find out the image in omega plane with respect to the image which is there in a z plane, that we assumed as in z plane there is a straight line which is parallel to the coordinates x axis and y axis in z plane. For that, what to do? Let us take axis x will be taken as a constant here, and we take y axis also constant. Then let us eliminate x and y from equation number 1. Here it is. Here in both the equations u and v, we can see x and y are available. So we need to eliminate x and y from equation number 1, not at once. We need to eliminate separately. That we need to keep it in a mind. So we are going to eliminate separately, one by one. For that, what to do? So we take squaring and adding equation number 1. Okay, if we square equation number 1, what happens? U square is equal to e raised to ex square into cos square x. Ex square is nothing but e raised to 2x. So we will be getting u square plus v square, because squaring then adding also. So u square or LHS, square of the LHS plus square of the LHS. So u square plus v square, that is equal to, here we can see, e raised to 2x into cos square y plus e raised to 2x into sin square y. Therefore we can see u square plus v square will be equal to e raised to 2x common term, cos square plus sin square will be equal to 1. So this I call it as one more result. I call it as equation A. Similarly, this is one point. We'll take other point. What is that? We here, for the other one, we take dividing equation 2 by 1 or 1 by 2. If we divide the equation, then we will be getting u by v is equal to. What is this now? U is e raised to, we take v by u. Then we will be getting the equation e raised to x into sin y divided by e raised to x into cos y. Therefore, e raised to x get cancelled, sin by cos is tan. Therefore, v by u is equal to tan y. So I call it as u by v is equal to tan y. I call it as equation B. So here we got two results. So how to utilize these two results to go through the next discussion here. So we'll take one by one, because already we have taken x is constant and y is constant. So we treated x and y are the we are going to take a straight line with respect parallel to coordinate axis x and y. So for that we take case 1. What case 1 says here? First we take, let x is equal to c1. And what is c1 here? This c1 is nothing but a constant. Okay, constant. Then equation number 2 becomes, equation A becomes. This equation A becomes, if you substitute x is equal to c1 in equation A, then what we will be getting? U square plus v square, which is equal to e raised to 2 times c1. We can see e raised to 2 times c1, again it becomes a constant. When it is a constant, so let us say this is it is equal to r square. Therefore we got u square plus v square is equal to r square. I call it as equation number 2. Then what this represents? U square plus v square is equal to r square. It represents, so equation number 2 represents equation of a circle center origin and radius r, which is in omega plane, because it is represented with respect to u and v in omega plane. Means very clearly we got one result, that is a straight line which was parallel to x axis, it produces a circle in omega plane. So let us take second case. In second case we take y is equal to c2, second one. Again c2 is nothing but a constant. Therefore equation A becomes, equation we'll take B here. Equation B becomes u by v by u is equal to tan y. Therefore v by u is equal to tan c2, because y is equal to c2 that we substituted. And we'll take this tan c2 is nothing but m, that is nothing but a slope of a tangent m. Therefore v is equal to, let us take this u to the other end, then it becomes u into m or m into u. What it represents? We know that it represents, I call it as equation number 3. Then equation number 3 represents equation of a straight line. Equation of a straight line passing through the origin. Passing through the origin in omega plane. Okay. So two discussions we observed here. One, when we took x is equal to c1, which is a constant. So that time we got x is equal to c1 means what? We have taken equation of a straight line parallel to y-axis. That time we got a circle. So we will produce that in terms of a conclusion here. We go through conclusion, what it says. Okay, we'll take a conclusion here. In both the cases, we have taken a straight line parallel to axis. A coordinates x axis and y axis. In first case what we have done, we have taken x is equal to c1. X is equal to c1 means what? Equation of a straight line parallel to y axis. So this is x is equal to c1. It is in z plane. What happens in the omega plane? In omega plane, we got, due to that equation, we got u square plus v square equal to r square, which is nothing but equation of a circle. Equation of a circle, that I take u square plus v square is equal to r square. Okay. Then in second case, we have taken y is equal to c2, which is constant. Y is equal to c2 means what? We have drawn a equation of a straight line, y is equal to c2, parallel to x-axis. Due to that, we got a result, v is equal to mu. We can see equation of a straight line, y is equal to mx plus c, where there is no c, so y is equal to mx like. So, here u and v are the ordinates in omega plane. Therefore, we can see here, due to this second equation of a straight line from z plane, it produces one more equation of a straight line in omega plane, so which passing through the origin. So this is v is equal to m u. Okay, now let us draw a tangent to this. If you draw a tangent to this, then automatically between these two we will be getting 90 degree angle. And if you see here also, due to this we are getting 90 degree angle. Means in this case we can see theta is equal to 90 degree in both. Therefore, we can conclude it like this. The x-axis in z-plane maps into a equation of a straight line in omega plane, and a straight line which was parallel to y-axis, it maps in z-plane, it maps into a equation of a circle in omega plane. Thank you.